Hi everyone, welcome back to Wisnose Tech News and Reviews. Today we have a heart rate accuracy test between two great smartwatches. So the first one is the Amazfit GTR 3 Pro. This is the all new smartwatch, top of the range from Huami Amazfit, and it's going head to head with the Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2. So these are very smart smartwatches, and they're very sporty as well. So we'll be taking a look at their optical heart rate sensors on the back of the smartwatches. The benchmark to the test will be a Polar H10 ECG chest strap, the most accurate in the market. Anyways, without further ado, let's get into the accuracy test.
If you are new to Wisnose Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way.
If you've been watching Wisnose Tech News and Reviews for a while, you would know that I've made a couple of reviews on the Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2 because I think that its medical pinpoint accuracy is spot on, and it does offer so much in the sportiness as well as in the medical range. For example, it's got an excellent ECG monitor. It's got an actual blood pressure monitor right on the watch, and yes, it must be calibrated, but it is so accurate. It might not have the best collection of sport modes, but the optical heart rate sensor on the back of the Samsung watch, wow, it's absolutely great. But today we do have a good competitor, and that is the all-new Amazfit GTR 3 Pro. So if you do recall, we had the Amazfit GTR, then we had the GTR 2, and of course we had the middle range smartwatches such as the GTR 2e. Well, the 3 actually comes in just as 3 or the 3 Pro. And to me, it sounds like they're going down the Huawei route, where they've got just the GT model and then the GT2 and the GT3 Pro. Anyways, this smartwatch is brand new. I got it delivered yesterday and it looks absolutely astounding. 1.45 inches. Wow. This is a 3D display. It's got the deepest blacks I've seen on a smartwatch so far. It's got a massive 150 sport modes. That is just wowzers. It's got 6 auto-detected activities. It's got an improved optical heart rate sensor, well, improved from the prior GTR and GTR 2. I really want to get this watch into a test against another very strong contender. So there we go, that's the roundabout about the Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2 as well as the Amazfit GTR 3 Pro. So as I mentioned earlier, the benchmark to this test was actually an ECG's chest strap, the Polar H10. And the ECG chest strap from Polar, or specifically the H10, is actually used around the globe by researchers, by sports science professionals, as well as professional athletes, because of its very high accuracy. So there we go. First, we're going to go through the results of the chest strap, and then we'll compare the two watches against those results. Let's do it. I actually did the accuracy test during my tennis workout because on Saturday mornings I play tennis at my local club, and these two watches were on me. And as I mentioned earlier, first we'll go through the results from the chest strap and then we'll get into the watches. So on the Polar H10, as you can see on the screen right now, the average heart rate was registered at 124 beats per minute, while the max reached quite a high peak during a 40-minute game, and that was 173 beats per minute. So first of all, let's take a look at the Galaxy Watch Active 2 results, and then we'll get to the Amazfit. And now if we take a look at the chart from the Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2, so let me just get the watch off and we'll put it up there. So there we go. So this is the watch, and this is the optical heart rate sensor that was used to get these results. So we can see that the average heart rate was actually registered or measured over the 40 odd minutes, about 41 minutes, was 130 beats per minute. So that means that it is overstating the average by 6 beats per minute. But the peak was registered at 166 beats per minute, and that is actually 7 below the highest peak as registered by Polar H10. So what we can see is that yes, The average is higher because it does seem that the Polar H10 has cuts in its data. Because as I was moving around, obviously the strap could be slightly detached from my actual chest, and we see these drops. Obviously, where over the 40 odd minute period, we have these blank columns or blank data points, they would go into the average calculation and dropping and reducing, hence the average. But the Samsung missed the highest peak, and the peak was 173 beats per minute. So all in all, I think we sort of expected the average to be slightly higher on the Polar H10, and we see that coming through on the Samsung, although the Samsung didn't quite do it with the peak. Anyway, now let's take a look at a Amazfit GTR 3 Pro's results. Okay, so we've got the two smartwatches here. One is the Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2. The other, this big, bright, and super good looking watch, is the Amazfit GTR 3 Pro. And this is not me trying to advertise this because it's not a sponsored video. I actually went out and I bought both of these. But let me just tell you that the Samsung result is slightly better, because what we see on the Amazfit GTR 3 Pro is that the average is registered at 125 beats per minute. So even though it looks very close to the Polar H10 average, we know that the Polar H10 did get disconnected occasionally. So you can see the chart from the Polar H10, we see those blank results, and that would drive the total average over the 40 minutes of the beats per minute slightly down. So we would be expecting somewhere around 130 beats per minute, as we saw on the Samsung, but the GTR 3 Pro shows us only 125 beats per minute. Let's look at the max value. So 156 beats per minute. This was the max, the peak, as registered by the Amazfit. Polar H10 got it at 173 beats per minute. So we have an understatement of about 17 beats per minute. And I'll tell you what, that is huge. We are talking about a 10% understatement. That is quite significant. On the average, I think it's about 5%, but on the max, wow. 10%, that's quite significant. Now, I'm sure that because this is a new smartwatch, it just made it to the market, there might be future updates coming. They will calibrate the results. Whatever they do, they better do it, because it's such a great smartwatch, and it's a shame to be let down by the optical heart rate sensor. And at the end of the day, your heart rate monitoring is probably the most important function of any smartwatch. That's why you get it. You want to get fitter, you want it to count your steps, and you want your intensity of activities to be measured well. And the intensity at which you exercise is actually a derivative of your heart rate. So the higher the heart rate, the more intense a workout is. Anyways, that's me blabbering on, but here we go. We see the results. So Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2 has an understatement of the peak by 7 beats per minute. That's round about 4%. The understatement on the Amazfit is quite significant, 10%. So 156 beats per minute against the H10 chest strap, which shows us 173 beats per minute. These are the results. Keep watching us for a full, deep, and comprehensive review of the Amazfit GTR 3 Pro. Thanks for watching another video from Wes Knows. If you enjoyed the content, please drop me a like. And if you want to see more of the same, hit the red subscribe button below the video. And I'll see you in the next one.